Hey guys, what's going on? Vin Ferretti, and welcome to another exclusive crypto video. And today's video is going to be talking about Binance and how you guys can start to purchase these altcoins. I had a lot of questions last night on my video about Ripple. How can I purchase Ripple? And here it is. So this is the exchange that I use, or I actually use Bittrex, but I'm starting to transfer to Binance because Bittrex is not accepting any more users. And Binance is just extremely nice. It's not even a year old. I'm going to get all into it. But before I get into that, I want to let you guys know I am not a licensed professional by any means. So anything I say or do is off my own research, my own humble opinions. So you guys should go out there, do your own research, do your own due diligence before investing in anything in cryptocurrency. So let's get into it. Binance, obviously a very clean exchange, as you guys can see. It is super clean, super, super nice. They're obviously updating this all the time. They actually just list Trig today, which is nice. We can maybe check that out. But we're going to be looking at how to deposit this Bitcoin into your wallet so you guys can start purchasing this altcoin phenomenon that I am obsessed with, because the coins are just such, they're just so volatile, and they're so, I personally think they're easy to read. And once you are able to know how to trade these altcoins, you can make so much more profit on it compared to how much that you can make just from shorting Bitcoin, selling and buying back. So let's look into that. That's actually go to the BTC wallet and show you guys how to deposit a BTC. So I don't really have anything in here. I have 1 cent, woo. But I will obviously be depositing my Bittrex account to Binance because I want to be using the same exchange as you guys, so I can be kind of informative talking about, oh, the exchange listed at the same price. Because as you guys can see, this is TradingView. This is another type of charting tool and that I like to use. But let's say right now it's at 0.1120, and then let's look at it fluctuates a little bit, so it's at 0.11227. I mean, it has been bouncing back and forth on Bittrex, but we obviously want to be able to have the same prices when we are talking about some coins that are about to break resistance, break support, or break an overall flag pattern. So let's look into that. So we're going to go into our wallet. As we see, we have Bitcoin, so we'll be depositing Bitcoin, and we will click deposit. We will have an address right here. We're going to copy that address, go back into the Bitcoin wallet. We're going to send that to that address, and we're going to enter the max. So I only have $9, so it's actually not even beneficial for me to send. I'll have to pay more to send it there. But if you guys transfer this money to GDAX, which I have a video on in my channel, if you just look on my YouTube channel and click search Coinbase to GDAX, whatever the name of the video is, it will pop right up, and you guys can show how to get your Bitcoin from Coinbase to GDAX. I also have a link in the description below if you guys don't have Bitcoin to go purchase it. You guys don't need to use that link, but it does give you a free $10 if you purchase over $100 or more. But so yeah, you're gonna wanna, you'll put the address in, and then you'll do continue, you'll send it, you'll enter if you have 2FA, the 2FA, and it'll eventually get into your Binance account. So once you have this money in this Binance account, you will be able to start trading these altcoins. Woohoo! But before we start that, I wanna go over how you guys can start trading, how you guys can kind of trade this coin. So let's go right into Ripple, let's talk about it. This thing did freeze on me a little earlier, so it shouldn't freeze. If it does, then I'll just close out and talk about it and try to give you guys just a nice view. But it is going into XRP, which is nice. So it might honestly trade, but we'll just talk about it. So here's the limit buy. So this limit buy is basically saying I want to buy it at this price. If it, I want to buy it at this price. Once it hits this price, let me buy it. So you have to do an order about down here. So you can do a limit buy of 11193. So if it does, if someone does end up going down to that, then you will purchase at that price. If you do market buy, you'll purchase at whatever the next price is. So if there's a spread of about, let's say it's at 11000, and then the buys are only 10,000, you'll purchase it at 11,000. And if you do a limit buy, it's just saying if someone wants to accept an offer for 10,000, I'm selling it. But a market buy obviously says that you're going to purchase at the market price, which is whatever someone is wanting to accept for a sell. A stop limit is when you want to make, basically set a stop loss. So if it, let's say if someone accepts 11,000, I want to sell. So if you're protecting yourself, if someone accepts 11,000, I want to sell it at 10,500. So you're protecting yourself from a big drop if it does break a support. Let's say the support's at 11,000, someone accepts it for 10,000. 10,999, then your order will start to fill and you'll sell right away, as that was a support and it personally broke that, thinking that it's going to go down. Now this can work as well as for a resistance. So if it does go up and you want to purchase, let's say if someone purchases, their resistance is at 12,000, and someone purchases at 12,000 Satoshi, then it's saying, when this purchase at 12,000 Satoshi, put my order in for 12,100 Satoshi, so you get filled on that uptrend, as well as not really worrying about having it bounce within the support resistance and not being able to fill while it is going up. Your best bet, though, if you're going to be trading these volatile cryptocurrencies and wanting to catch it on that upswing and making sure that you have that kind of solid amount of market buy, solid price on that upswing, is right when it breaks it, you can set that market. Because sometimes if you set a limit, what it will do is it will jump. If you're too kind of like close to the price, it will jump your order and you won't end up getting filled. And that's just not good, because then you'll see it going up. So it does cost a little more in fees, not that much. And it might cost a little more if you're doing market, because the price will be a little more. But overall, if you're catching it and this thing's jumping your limit buy, then that means it's on an absolute bull. So you're going to want to get into it, going to want to do that market buy. And make sure that you are going to get filled so you don't miss this upswing. So that's basically what these are. I'm going to see if it loads. So it is loading. So you can see I'm going to just sell. Let's say I sell 100% of my XRP, if it even lets me fill. So it won't even let me sell this 0.0035 because it's so low. But if you were to sell it, you would do obviously put in your price and then do sell XRP. It'll pop up right here because it's a market, and you'll sell it at the price of 11,179. Sometimes when you place it, it might bounce back and forth, so you might end up selling it down here just because maybe you have your BTC values a lot, and the first BTC value is only the first BTC value is only maybe 0.01 BTC, and you're selling Ripple that's worth 0.05 BTC. So I'll fill that first one and then fill that second one, and overall just make sure that you sell it all. If you do that limit, it'll only fill when someone's offering that certain price. So like I said, you're going to want to send that Bitcoin to that wallet. So enter that address, obviously send the whatever you want to send max, whatever, how much Bitcoin you want to send. Once you get that Bitcoin, you can go in here and start trading. This is their kind of their view of their trading chart. I don't like it that much. I mean, TradingView is $15 more, and it's substantially going to help you a lot if you can just add all these indicators. I don't have any indicators at the moment because I'm not signed into my actual account, but you can have all these indicators and make sure that you are having these perfect charting tools to be able to profit on these altcoins. So that's the video for today. I hope you guys enjoy it. I'll probably be going live tonight talking about all the ICOs and all the investment platforms that I'm currently invested in. But if you guys want to get that set up, remember, purchase that Bitcoin in the link below, as well as sign up for Binance. It's also in the description below if you guys want to sign up. It's free to sign up. You can look at the back office, see what you like, and ultimately make your own decision on your own research and own due diligence. So I hope you guys end this Friday on a green note, roll into this weekend on a green note, and let's always be exclusive to crypto.